Hi Pisces, how are you? Welcome to your energy update. I hope everyone is doing fantastic, Pisces. Let's see here. What unexpected is coming towards you, Pisces? What unexpected is coming towards you? We're here in spring and we are about to experience new blossoming things in our life. Your energy levels could be going up. However, with with Saturn in Pisces, you could feel your energy, you know, this year, like it could be a little restrained, but don't worry about that. It's kind of just Saturn in your sign, kind of like putting this restrictive energy on you for you to kind of slow down a second so you can contemplate and think about things that you want to shift or maneuver here. But let's see here. What unexpected is coming towards you, Pisces? What unexpected is coming towards you, Pisces? What unexpected is coming towards you? What unexpected is coming towards you coming up? What unexpected? Why is this? Why is this Five of Cups? What unexpected? What is this? The fuck? Why? What unexpected? Why is this? Okay. The Wheel of Fortune in the reverse, Six of Cups in the reverse, and Seven of Wands. Okay, so there could be a situation coming up where you feel a little defeated or you feel like someone either doesn't have the energy to come towards you, and so maybe you're expecting something. Be careful with expectations, okay? You know, maybe you're waiting for something to come towards you. You see the energy building and something doesn't quite transpire the way you wanted to, or maybe your energy's lower, or something here from the past leaving, you know, and you feeling like it's some sort of loss here. Let's clarify these in detail because this is a very interesting... Very interesting. All right. What is this Six of Cups in the reverse? What is the Six of Cups? What unexpected is coming towards Pisces? Yeah. So there's some sort of love connection here that maybe someone has a challenging time moving away from something and you don't get the success or the reward that you want in this connection. Okay. What is the Seven of Wands? Seven of Wands in the reverse. Hierophant. I'm sorry, the Hermit in the reverse, and then Judgment. Yeah, I feel here like, yeah, you have to be careful about putting all your eggs in one basket, about putting too much energy or desire into someone here coming up. You know, make sure that you're using that time and that energy wisely and that you're focusing and putting it on you. Let's see here. What is this Wheel of Fortune? What an interesting way to start a video. What is this Wheel of Fortune? If you know me, you know I don't like these type of messages. But it's just reality, right? Like everything can't be all rosy sometimes. Knight of Cups. So I feel here that you're kind of getting inspired and feeling the emotions and whatnot and getting yourself like maybe being swept away here. But make sure, again, that you're listening to your intuition about the situation, Pisces, because you could then be met with something. You could be met with some sort of restraint here. Let's clarify these. What is this Three of Swords? What is this Three of Swords particularly? All right, these wanted to show. It's like it was at the bottom of the deck. I'm going to get again Nine of Wands, Three of Pentacles, and Seven of Swords here. Yeah. So someone here that you may want to build with could, again, sneak out, or maybe, you know, you feel the energy, the anticipation of them coming towards you, but then again, you know, it just doesn't happen, and then you feel defeated again. So make sure that you're not on that reoccurring cycle, and the best way to not be on that is, again, to temper your expectations, all right? Stop expecting, stop putting too much energy on something. Use your intuition here. What is this Three of Swords? And I feel like it's regards to love. Yeah, I feel here that if you wait around for someone, you know, there's times again, we feel the energy gaining momentum in a fiery climax. And then when it doesn't happen, you're like, oh man, you know, you feel defeated again. So it's like, make sure that you're not here waiting on something and continue to be persevere into something that's just not going to give you the results that you want, okay? Make sure that while you have this energy, while the spring is blossoming, while you have all this, make sure that you're pouring that love into you, not into external things and external people. What is this Five of Cups? And then we're going to move on from this message and get another one. What is this Five of Cups? what is this Five of Cups? Queen of Swords. And then you shut down again, okay? Eight of Wands. Communication. Another message, again, is to, if you're holding on from this lingering resentment from the past, or maybe from the Pisces new moon energy, another type of different message from this, because we kind of started backwards, is to make sure that you are ridding yourself of those energies and allow yourself to be more open, right? So new communication can come in, okay? If you're holding on to past resentments, make sure that you continue to plant the seeds. You're gonna know in your situation, right? You have to use your intuition, because for some of you, it's you need to open up more. But for some of you, it's like you need to really manage your expectations and not put so much energy on someone and you know, kind of just like obsess over them, right? Let's see what a different deck. What unexpected is coming towards Pisces? Square, challenge at the bottom of the deck. All right, I feel here, Pisces. And so all of these came out in the reverse. I didn't really shuffle them like that, but you know, all of these came out in the reverse. We have Venus, Taurus, semi-sextiling, allowing the fourth house, again, which was the Four of Wands. That was in another video that I pulled out, actually. And then Ten of, it's really going to depend on you, I'm feeling, so this is a potential in the air, right? This is a potential in the air. There's a lot of potential for love, a lot of potential for, you know, career here and stability. However, in the beginning, okay, coming up, especially as Saturn enters our sign on March 7th, in the beginning, it might feel like the opposite, right? Because sometimes when we're working on energy, it's going to purge inside of you everything that is not allowing that energy, right? Which is oftentimes the complete opposite. You're going to feel like, what? Like, this is like, you know what I'm saying? For some of you, it depends on you. It depends how much you're resisting. But I feel here that you really have to open yourself up to receive love. And for some of you, whatever pains, whatever you go through, you know, see it not as something like, well, life is just like breaking me down, but see it as a lesson, as a challenge. Okay, keep that excitement. This is what all this year is about, essentially, the self-mastery within, to keep going. Even though you don't see these things on the outside yet, you have to continue to put in the work. It's like you have to continue to be practical when it comes to your money, okay? You have to continue to stay on top of it and put in consistent effort when it comes to your money and your stability. This is not a time to drop the ball. This is not the time to like go for a little bit and then start getting discouraged, okay? There's a lot of opportunities here in your surroundings, but it's really going to depend on how you show up, okay? And that's everything in life, but more so in this time, okay? Let's see here. What unexpected is coming towards Pisces? What unexpected is coming towards Pisces? Empress. Okay, this is what we're talking about. Empress. What unexpected is coming towards Pisces? Page of Pentacles. This wants to show. The Fool. Make sure you're not being reckless, right? Knight of Wands. Okay, all right. So I'm getting here. Six of Pentacles. Life is asking you, all right. I'm getting the message here. I'm getting, it's coming together. This is gonna be a short video. So Empress energy, you could be working your way up. You could be in this Empress energy right now. You could have been embodying this, you know, in the last couple of weeks, months, whatever, even though it's been challenging, we've been embodying, and the thing with self-mastery is maintaining the energy, right? So I'm seeing here, bottom of the deck, six of Pentacles, right? An equal give and take here. Make sure, Pisces, that yes, you are giving to things, but make sure that you're not rushing and being reckless and over-giving to something here. Make sure that you're taking the time to really analyze, but also it's like, this duality. It's about making decisions and not stalling too much, but taking the time to really figure out what is the right decision when it comes to your dreams. But make sure, you know, that you're not rushing too much into things, and that it's from a balanced place of not overgiving, of not giving too little, right? You have to maintain this Empress energy, because it could cause some disappointments when you get out of balance, and this is what could cause some lack here. So there's a lot of opportunities in your environment here for love and for money specifically. Okay, I see here a lot of things, but Saturn in your sign on March 7th here is going to really call for that discipline and that balance in your life, okay? It's, again, you have to maintain this Empress energy so you don't get disappointed and then go into a downward spiral of lack here. Again, it is this balance of putting effort but not overgiving to people or things that you shouldn't, and or it's not holding back too much. Again, it's like the right porridge here, okay? Balance coming up. So it's more so than ever, but tons of opportunities I'm seeing, tons of opportunities. I'm just kind of cautioning you, right? These are the cards cautioning you to be careful about your emotions and your imbalances that could cause you delays in the money and love that you want, okay? What unexpected is coming towards Pisces? I don't know if I'm gonna post this video. You guys know I like really like high vibes, yay, fun, lovey, great energy. But it's, you know, I gotta do it, because when I don't post the video and I'm like, damn, like it occurred. When I post the video, I find that, at least for myself, it occurs like 2 to 3 weeks down the line, and it didn't make sense when I made the video, but then I'm like, okay. So that might be the case for you. Pisces, what's coming up for Pisces? Joy and delight. Okay, grounded and centered. So this is what I'm seeing, okay? Yeah. You know the thing of duality, okay? And I'm gonna show you. Lately, I've been noticing at the bottom of the deck, connect to Gaia, connect. I'm gonna point out this message. Lately, I've been noticing, especially in the past couple of 6 months, you know when you're, and it's not to say when you're experiencing so much joy, be careful, because you're gonna experience the adverse side of that, but duality. Make sure that when you have all this energy, make sure that you're not expanding your or expending your energy too much and pouring it into things too much, right? Because then you're gonna hit, you have to temper your energy. Again, it's all about balance here coming up. When you're experiencing this joy and delight, make sure that you're being thoughtful of where you put your energy, of not throwing too much energy out, because that's energy that you're gonna have to, again, balance and ground yourself again. So it's all about, again, this balance. It's going to be very, very important to ground yourself. And as a Saturn, as a sign that's very earthly, right, we're going to feel, because Pisces likes to be very whimsical in the air, fantasies, it's going to feel like it's anchoring. There could be like a tendency possibly for like a little depression or whatnot, you know, because it's like you don't like to be held down, Pisces. So that feels different. And so that difference can make you feel as if, you know, as if you're like moody, right? So it's all about really the self-mastery with your emotions. You've been practicing this over the past couple of years. This is what it's been about, really self-mastery and understanding how to balance your energy. Like, okay, I'm dehydrated. I need to drink massive amounts of water. I know that's linked so much to my mental clarity, to my body, to my digestive. Like, you know the things that you have to do. Okay, I've exhausted my energy. I have to rest. I have to rejuvenate my energy. It's not about, you know, because so much depends before on the old way of life, right? The rigid masculine structures in the past like year or two, right? We've been shifting. The earth has been ascending, and it's all about the energy dynamics more than ever. And all of us are much more aware of that, okay? And again, as we feel, we manifest. So we have to make sure that we are grounded so our 3D reality is not showing up chaotic, right? All right, what else is coming towards Pisces? A lot of joy and delight though, but you're gonna need to balance that energy. You're gonna need to balance that. A lot of joy, and if your heart is not open, if you have some blockages, right? When all this joy is coming in, it's purging. So you're gonna feel like, Right, so it's you're doing away so you can accept, open your heart, open your chakra systems here, balance throughout all this energy. There's a lot of energy sweeping through you, wanting to transition and change and stir things up for the better. But if you don't ground, it's gonna feel chaotic, okay? This is kind of like the energy. So I don't see bad things. I see marvelous things coming in for you, but it's gonna shake some things up. All right. What's coming in for Pisces? So what's coming in for Pisces? All right, that's kind of like a bit, like, I don't, okay, we're just kind of looking at it. It's got it. All right. Yeah. Again, it's interesting. It's interesting because, all right, tears of joy and sadness, okay? And then we have affirmations for healing the heart. As we're talking about the heart, there's marvelous things going to come, but you really have to adjust, okay? A lot of creativity is going to come in for you. So it's like oftentimes, right, this energy comes down and it's like we need some sort of outlet, some sort of creative outlet so we can express ourselves, so we can kind of channel that energy. But it's going to take a lot of rest and meditation for peace and serenity, okay, and healing waters for you to really heal. Again, the self-mastery of you know what you have to do. You know that it starts with your emotions. Why are you feeling certain things? I know that the Pisces new moon really kind of brought some things out. Like, I felt like, ew, you know? But also, I know that it's linked to my eating. But also, when you start to feel like a lot of energy comes down, a lot of, like, 5D energy, you feel this anxiousness and you don't feel it consciously, but you may start to eat. You may start to, like, overindulge in certain things, and that affects your digestive, which affects your energy. So it all starts with all these energies coming out. If you're able to sit with it rather than find something to compensate for that, right? That's what it's going to take. So quiet down. Again, I see a lot of energy going to be coming down and it's going to be good, but it's so much energy. Sometimes a good energy throws you off balance too. You know what I'm saying? All right, last to wrap this up. What unexpected? What's coming in for Pisces? Balance. Okay, we're gonna balance. Yes, and this is what's happening. To balance out, sometimes it's gonna throw your balance off. Love. So there's gonna be a lot of heart chakra energy. Okay, a lot of heart chakra. You need to open your heart to joy. And if you're not as open to that, it's really going to throw you off balance. I see a lot of clearing when it comes to your heart. And quite interesting because I've been doing the infrared sauna, and the two that I have been really focusing on has been the green light heart chakra and orange energy, which is like solar or sacral type of energy, creativity, like bringing, like clearing out repressed feelings as well. So there's gonna be a lot of balance in regards to that, especially again, the Pisces energy. Well, we have, what is that? What new moon? Hold on, Virgo. Oh, okay. This is making sense now. I just looked. And on the 7th, there is a Virgo full moon. Okay, this makes, now that I just saw that, it makes a whole lot of sense, okay? Virgo is your opposite, okay? And maybe in the past years, I have noticed that, again, you know, it could throw you a little bit off balance, the Virgo full energy. But again, Virgo is like Venus, you know, embodying this love and embodying more balance. It makes a lot of sense now, embodying the balance, right? If you got to this end of this video and I said this Virgo full moon is going to be, it could shake you up a bit, but it's going to be good. So just kind of go with it. Be mindful that you need to stay more balanced than ever, okay, guys? Communication. All right, that's what I have for you. What's the advice for Pisces? What is the advice for my Pisces friends? Universal light and rebirth. Yeah, keep in mind that this universal light is coming in, but it's especially in your season, in your, you know, in your Pisces season, this is a complete rebirth for you. So just be mindful that nothing is permanent. It's all transient type of energy. But wow, after seeing that Virgo full moon on March 7th, oh, on March 7th, the freaking day of Saturn coming into. Okay. This makes sense now, okay, guys? So I hope that this was sort of helpful. And as I said, the energy starts to make sense like 2 to 3 weeks out. That's about 2 weeks out. So let me know, Pisces. Don't get discouraged. Don't, you know, we're feeling all light and energy now. Make sure that you're just going with the flow. All right. I love you guys. I hope this was helpful. I will see you soon.